Hey, this is Phil Lilley, Lilley's Landing Resort and Marina on Lake Taneycomo. Jackson and I are out here doing one cast this evening. It's Tuesday the 20th of June. It's about 6 o'clock in the evening, maybe a little bit after. They're running some water, I'd say about 2 units. They're scheduled to run 4, but they've said 4 for the last few evenings, and they're not running 4, it's more like 2. It's hard to say, especially here at Lookout. But I'm going to drift. I'm going to throw a 16th ounce sculpin jig with a brown head, 2 pound line. I guess that has been the hot ticket in the mornings. So we'll see if they're gonna do anything in the evening with the water running. I'm gonna switch the camera and go down. Go ahead and fish this pocket first. This little eddy right here, and then I'm gonna, ooh, there's some nice fish right down there. But they're suckers, I can see them. Oh, I see some trout out there, though. There's a trout in front of me. Nothing on the first cast. Ran into Tony on the way up here. He's drifting the scuds, said he's catching a few. I almost need to keep moving down with this. I was gonna say, I have not been fishing much. And when I have been going out, I haven't been doing very good here. It's I have heard. Oh, he let go. Jig's okay. He's about 14 inches. He's fighting good. The sculpin jig has really been working good, is what I've been told. Especially early in the morning, but some late in the evening. I do have Point Royal right behind me. Surprised nobody's down here fishing. I'll work my way down. Hey, oh, let go again. I didn't get a good hook set on that one. I did on the first one. Night crawlers has been really good. My longtime guest, staying at the resort right now, Steve, said that they've been going out and fishing a nightcrawler tip with a white power bait egg. They're not getting out till 8:30 in the morning, and they're catching a lot of really nice fish between the resort and Trout Hollow. I'm seeing a lot of fish out in front of me. Nothing big. Didn't get a good hook set on that. Well, maybe I did. It's a little better fish though. Hopefully I'll hold on to this one. Okay. Hook came out. I think it got stuck in the net. Too bad to get my hand around. Say about 17 inches, maybe. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, sculpting jigs doing pretty good. Ooh, that was a nice fish. Up. I think I had a bite. Looks like Tony's coming back up. Another one. Small one. He ought to come over here. Throw a jig. I'll text him in a minute. Or, I don't know, they're probably doing pretty good drifting scuds. My son Caleb came in this morning and his three kids, so we got the grandkids here for a week. Might get them on one cast, might not, I don't know. Ah, Sarah's kids are here from Kansas City too. There's one little one, like really little. That's brown bait right there. Actually, the water is really perfect speed for fishing over here in this eddy, because what the water I'm fishing has got a little current, but not much. Just one big eddy right here, right? Not even an eddy, it's a back, it's like backwater. There's another bite. Go on down a little ways. I know a bunch of big fish hang out in this eddy too, so. Ricky Lysak and Steve Dickey, probably all doing the same group. Surprised they're going in this early. Oh my gosh. breakers. Gonna put me up on the bank. Golly. Missed him. What do you think? Looks like they're jigging again. Throwing a jig. Oh, there's a bump. I like this spot right here. There's a shade out in the water where I'm throwing. Trolling motor stuck on the bottom. I'll get it up. I'm done here in just a second. That was a nice fish. Okay. Nope, I'm loose. They're starting to midge down here, hit the surface. There's a lot of geese behind me. See all the geese? Whole bunch. I'm still in a bunch of dead water here. Kind of what I thought. Oh man, that was a good fish. I think my knot failed. Yep. Sure did. This is Vanish fluorocarbon. That's one thing on your knots. You got to be very intentional on your knots. Obviously, I was not very intentional. And you need to net wet the line when you draw it tight, which I don't think I did. Gun it. It was bigger than that 17 inch fish that I caught earlier. I got a pretty good look at him. There's a lot of fish, a lot of birds there. Fish right there. It was going to be the last little jig. It's going to bring it in. So I can't catch a big fish. Lock him up. Missed one. That's a little one. He can grow up to be a pretty fish. Very silver, big old fins. Getting a little bit more current here. Line went slack, and I set it, but I didn't set it like I meant it. Should have set it harder than that. It is hard to see this fluorocarbon. It really disappears. Fish in front of the boat. They were watching my jig as it went by. Ooh, let me tap that one. Ooh, there's a nice fish. A couple of them. Come on. Okay. Okay, just a couple more casts because I'm almost out of the eddy. I think they're already starting to drop the water too. Maybe. I think they're only running like 1.5. Yeah, I'm pretty much out of the, oh, I had three trout chase that jig up. One more cast. Yeah, I'm not seeing as many fish. Oh, there's one. Nice one. I'm not seeing as many fish now that I got out of the eddy. And it's, of course, not as deep here. Yeah, this is the last cast. Definitely a lot more fish in that slower eddy water than out here in the current. Well, that was fun. I don't know how many fish I caught. Broke off, missed. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again tomorrow.